and welcome to Letter M Day. So today we are talking all about things that start with the letter M. First thing is me. M is for Mrs. Miller. That's me. So that starts with a Miller at the beginning. Another thing that starts with the letter M, I think you guys like these. Markers. Markers start with And I have another thing that starts with the letter M. A coffee mug. Oh, I love coffee. But the one thing that starts with the letter M that I love the most, any guesses? Monsters! I love monsters. I think that monsters are so cute and cuddly. I just love them. So today it's going to be all about monsters with Mrs. Miller. So I hope you are excited to learn about some monsters because I love them. And I know sometimes people can think monsters are scary, but I want to change that today because I think they're cute and cuddly. And of course we know that they're just pretend. So we are going to learn about monsters. We have a monster story. We have a monster drawing that we're going to do. And did you know the one thing that monsters love the most? What do you think monsters love the most? I wonder. Milkshakes. They love milkshakes. Get up and do this dance with me.
Repeat after me.
Repeat after me.
Oh, a milkshake.
Oh, a milkshake.
A sticky, sticky waffle.
A sticky, sticky waffle.
A mozzarella pizza.
A mozzarella pizza.
All the eggs are broken.
All the eggs are broken.
That was really nothing.
That was really nothing.
We can do it British.
We can do it British.
Oh, a milkshake.
Oh, a milkshake.
A sticky, sticky waffle.
A sticky, sticky waffle.
A mozzarella pizza.
A mozzarella pizza.
All the eggs are broken.
All the eggs are broken.
That was really nothing.
That was really nothing.
We can do it quiet. We can do it quiet. Oh, a milkshake.
Oh, a milkshake.
A sticky, sticky waffle.
A sticky, sticky waffle.
A mozzarella pizza.
A mozzarella pizza.
All the eggs are broken.
All the eggs are broken.
That was really nothing.
That was really nothing.
We can do it louder.
We can do it louder.
Oh, a milkshake.
Oh, a milkshake.
A sticky, sticky waffle.
A sticky, sticky waffle.
A mozzarella pizza.
A mozzarella pizza.
All the eggs are broken.
All the eggs are broken.
That was really nothing.
That was really nothing.
We can do it backwards.
We can do it backwards.
Oh, a milkshake.
Oh, a milkshake.
A sticky, sticky waffle.
A sticky, sticky waffle.
A mozzarella pizza.
A mozzarella pizza.
All the eggs are broken.
All the eggs are broken.
That was really something.
That was really something.
We are really awesome.
We are really awesome.
Yeah.
Woo. That was a fun dance. Monsters love milkshakes. So now that we got our wiggles out and we danced to the milkshake song with the monsters, we're going to read a story. This will be a perfect way for our bodies to cool down after that little exercise that we just did. So I have a super fun story for you. It's called There's a Monster in Your Book. And this is kind of like an interactive story where I'm going to need your help. I'm going to be asking you to help me do some things in this story. So I hope that you're ready. This story was written by Tom Fletcher, and the illustrator of this story is Greg Abbott. So let's begin. There's a monster in your book. Oh no! There's a monster in your book. Look at that monster right there. Do you see what I mean? That monsters are just so cute and cuddly. Let's try to get him out, shake the book and turn the page. Are you ready? We're gonna shake the book. Shake it up. Okay, let's turn the page. Nice try. That knocked him over, but he's still in your book. Tickle his feet and turn the page. Let's tickle his feet. Are you ready? Tickle, 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 tickle. I'm gonna hold it up close. Tickle his feet. Let's find out if that worked. That didn't work. He's just laughing and he's still in your book. Try blowing him away. Blow really hard and turn the page. Are you ready? I'm gonna put it up close so you can blow with me. Let's see if that worked. That's better. Now he's far away, but he's still in your book. Tilt the book to the left. So I'm gonna tilt him to the left. Let's see if that helped. Now he's over here, but he's still in your book. Tilt the book to the right. Let's tilt him to the right. Let's find out if that helped. He's hanging on. Look at him holding on so tight. What a naughty little monster. Give the book a good wiggle. Are you ready? We're gonna hold it like this and we're going to wiggle it. Wiggle the book, wiggle the book, wiggle the book. Let's find out if that helped. Good, now he's back over there, but there's still a monster in your book. Try spinning the book around and around. I'm gonna put it flat again and we're gonna spin it around and around. Ooh, there he goes. Okay, let's find out if that helped. Look, he's dizzy. Quick, make a loud noise. Everyone make a loud noise. Rah! It's working. He's running away. Make the noise again, but louder. So make the noise. Roar. He's gone. There isn't a monster in your book anymore. Now he's in your room. Quickly call him back. Monster, come back. Oh no, now he's in the room. Look, here he is. He's coming back. Keep calling him. Monster, come here, little monster. Can you see him? He's coming. Phew, he's back in your book. You don't want a monster loose in your room. This book is probably the best place to keep him. Look how happy he looks. Monster, you can stay here in this book. Pet Monster's head and say good night. Let's pet his head. Good night, Monster. I'm gonna hold him up close. Go ahead and pet his head. Say good night, Monster. I hope you enjoyed that story. I love that story. There's a monster in the book and now he's fast asleep. I hope you had so much fun with that story, and make sure to remember the book is a good place for the monster. Hi everyone, I hope you are having so much fun on Letter M Day, and I hope you are enjoying learning all about monsters. I hope you are realizing that monsters, of course, are pretend, and they're just cute and cuddly, so I hope that you are learning to love them as much as I love them. So our next activity that we're going to do is we are going to learn how to draw a monster together. So we are going to head over this way to this desk right here, and we are going to draw a monster together. So it's going to be a directed drawing where it's a step-by-step activity, and you will learn how to draw a monster. Come on!
For our next activity, we are going to learn how to draw a monster. Now, the fun thing with monsters is that there's no right or wrong way to make one. So right here, you can see two examples. This one is more of a round monster, and this one is more of a square monster. So we are going to go step by step and learn how to draw one together, and there's going to be times where I tell you that you can add some of your own details, because again, they're pretend, so we can make them how we like to make them. So all you're going to need for this activity is some white paper, or another suggestion, since you are going to be doing your journal writing page today about the letter M for M Day, you can do your monster drawing right on your journal writing paper if you would like to also. And then if you want to color it, you will need crayons or markers, whichever you prefer. And of course, a pencil. Now I am actually going to do the drawing in a marker because it is easier for you to see the marker than it is for you to see the pencil on the video. So I will be using a marker, but I do encourage you to use a pencil. Should you need to erase, it would be much easier. So what we're going to do is, for the first step, I am going to show you how to do the rounded monster, but if you want to do the square monster, hang tight and I'm going to show you the first step for that one. So this is specifically for the rounded monster. I'm going to start at the very bottom of my paper, and I am going to go up and make a big rainbow arch all the way until I get to the other side of my paper, a big rainbow arch. Now, if you are wanting to make a square monster, here's your example. All you have to do is make a straight line. You're making a square, so a straight line up, a straight line over, and a straight line down, and that will be your square monster. So you can pick whichever one you prefer. I'm going to stick with the rounded monster for this drawing. Next, I'm going to add the monster horns at the top, and we want to make the horns pointy. So let me show you how we're going to do that. I'm going to go up near, not all the way to the top of my paper, but near the top of my paper, and I am going to make a curved line, just like that, a curved line touching my monster's head. And then I'm going to go back up to the point where I started, and I'm going to make another curved line going back to his head. So two curved lines, that's how I make it pointy at the top. If yours is rounded, that's perfectly okay too. Whichever you prefer. So then I'll do the same thing on the other side. Start at the top and a curved line to our monster's head. Start at the top and a curved line to our monster's head. I am going to make a three-eyed monster. You can choose how many eyes you would like to make. You could have it be a one-eyed monster, a two-eyed monster, a four-eyed monster, or like me, a three-eyed monster. Again, that's the fun thing about a monster, is you get to choose and be creative. So I'm going to make one eye right in the middle of his head, and then I'm going to add two more eyes right below. And for the next step is, I am going to make a half circle right inside, it's kind of like a curved rainbow arch, right inside each of those eyes. Now, if you're doing a pencil first, I would recommend that you leave it like that, and then when you're all done, you can go back with a black crayon or a black marker to color it in. Since I am already using a black marker, I'm going to go ahead and color in just the bottom part of those eyes, so they are nice and dark. One more to go. There we go. So there's my three-eyed monster. Now my monster is going to be a very happy monster. So we're going to give him a big smile. And now for the teeth, you can kind of choose. Let me show you two examples again. On this monster, I just gave him teeth at the bottom. And on this monster, I kind of alternated and I did top, bottom, top, bottom, top, bottom, top. So what I'm going to do for this one is, I am going to do the same thing where I alternate. I'm going to start at the top, and all it is a little triangle. So you're going to make little triangles I left some space in between, but this is your monster, so you can decide. If you want to fill his whole mouth with teeth, you're welcome to do that. If you want to do them just on the top, you can do that. If you want to do them just on the bottom, you can do that. Whatever you would like to do is perfect. Now the next step is I am going to make a wavy line from one side of the monster to the other side. So the way I do that is I make a line going up. It's like a zigzag line, up and down, 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 until I get to the other side. How are we doing? Are we good? Now the next thing I'm going to do, it's actually our last step, it's pretty easy peasy lemon squeezy to draw a monster, is we are going to add some hair to the outside of our monster. And the way I'm going to do that, again, if you want to now do that with a marker, you're welcome to do that, or you can do it with your pencil, whichever you prefer. So I am going to go around the whole entire outside of my monster, and I'm going to make little tiny wavy zigzag lines. I don't want to make them big and huge and make it look scribbly, like I can't see my monster anymore. So I'm going to show you just little wavy lines. Doesn't have to be perfect. See, I'm just going nice and quick around my monster, little lines. And this makes it look like our monster is hairy. Kind of like my hat that I'm wearing right now. There's lots of hair. I'm going to continue that until I get all the way to the other side. Done! And there you have a three-eyed monster, or however many eyes you chose. Now the last step would be to color your monster. Again, these are two examples that I have right here. You can use any colors you want, because again, you get to be creative because monsters are pretend. So this one I did yellow down at the bottom, I did purple at the top. I chose to leave the teeth white. You could do whatever you prefer. I gave him some orange horns, and then I always love to do a background on my pictures. If you've ever been inside my classroom, you know it's very colorful. I like lots of bright colors. So I always like to leave no white space, so I did the background on this one a green color. And then this monster over here, I did him purple on the bottom, and I made him blue all on his body. I left his white teeth, and then I gave him some green horns, and then I did a black background. I really like that one because it makes the colors nice and bright and colorful and stand out. And that, my friends, completes your monster drawing. I hope that you had so much fun, and I hope you enjoyed this activity.
Thank you all so much for joining me, Mrs. Miller, for Letter M Day. I hope you all had so much fun learning about monsters today, doing a little dance, reading a story, learning a directed drawing. Now you can go write in your journal entry what you enjoyed about today. And I hope that these videos brought a little bit of joy to your day today, the same joy that they brought me, feeling like I was able to be with you guys and share this experience with you. So thank you so very much for tuning in, and I will chat with you all soon. Bye, everyone.